Hello everybody, it's Els here, Elizabeth Craft Designs, from our home away from home. Let me see if I, there I come. See if everything works again. Hide my stand there. It's all a little bit different than in the studio, but it's working. I'm just going to see, I see comments as well. Hi Terry, Jennifer. And seven other people. I'm just going to wait for a minute. And I'm doing this live on a special day. Of course, we have the inauguration here of a new president. So I thought, well, a lot of you will be glued to the TV maybe today. And I did as well. Hi, Anita. Hi, Ina. Hi, Jennifer. Marga. Annelie. Hi, everybody. Cora, Mirjam. I heard in the Netherlands, for the people in the Netherlands, like more restrictions. I think the night clock is going in, avondklok. And only one person in your home. It's all changing by day almost. So it's going to be show and tell day. Because I got the most gorgeous samples in here from Karen. And Karen will be here. Oh, there she is. She's popping up. Karen is here. Karen Gerber, and she made these cards. So, of course, besides Anita, these are gorgeous samples and totally different again. And that's what I love about it. So I'm going to show and tell. I asked Karen to be here because she, you know, I'm going to do show and tell and I can show everything, but I don't know if I can tell everything. So if you have any questions, you can ask it. But big surprise and a treat. On Friday, and I forgot again. Oh, if Anna is here. Anna, can you post both the winners? My goodies. I forgot again. I forgot to write down the winners. You see, I'm like not solely myself here. It's still, it's different. My so Anna, if you are here, please post both the winners from Monday and Wednesday. If she's not, we will post it on the Elizabeth Craft Designs Facebook page. That is my mistake. I'm so sorry. So, but Karen will do the live on Friday. So Karen is going to show you how she creates her flowers. So yeah, can't wait for the Karen's live. I know, Tracy. I'm very excited about that as well. So, yeah, super excited. I don't see Anna. I have to say, I'm sorry. So like, comment and share for a chance for the $50 gift certificate. But I forgot to, on Monday, I forgot to write the name down. And now I forgot to write both down. So if Anna is not here, I will post it on the Elizabeth Craft Designs Facebook page. Sorry about that. Okay, so we're going to start. I have 8 gorgeous samples to show, I have to say. And hi, Sue. And Cherie from Edmonton. I'm close to you, Edmonton. You know that. Well, not close, a few hours away. So, florals number 5. That is the one that Karen used for these flowers. And I think she used the soft finish cardstock, if I see that well. And then I'm going to get it keep it closer because I want to kind of hold in an angle. And my light is not perfect here because I'm working with daylight lamps. But look at the layers. The paper from the Reminiscence, the book. And that's what I love about it. Because Karen really liked stamps from the Planner Essentials. I recognize that one. And then the bow here, of course. And some roughing up on the edges from the paper. You know, I do that a lot. Some mirror board here. So lots of layers. A banner, the congrats, that probably comes from one of our sets. I don't know, there's some. No, Karen, you don't need to be nervous. You are going to be fine. You are going to be fine. In the center, those are prills, I'm pretty sure. And Karen, if I say something that's not correct, Karen, what I forgot to ask you, which ink do you use to color? So which ink do you use to color? So like the leaves and the inside here of that green. Do you use distress ink or do you use, any ink? What kind of ink do you use? That would be great. Yeah, Els, this is a gorgeous card. Gorgeous card. So pre also a little bit of shading. And again, see like the small flowers. I love that, of course. And that's what we have in each set now. But this is just, I think that's just the smallest here that she used. So I love the layering. So you see one size, two size, three sizes. So, and what I see here, so Karen did two layers and offset it. And of the same size. So this is the same, two times the same size. This is two times the same size. And this is two times the same size. And then some single flowers. Love that. And I think she actually might use, yeah, she used one, two, three, four. So she used all four sizes. One, two, three, four. No, this is the, this is one, is this one. Yeah. But gorgeous, just gorgeous. Some circles, some stitch circles. So just combine. Use the soft finish on all the flowers. And which ink, Karen? Because did I miss that? The comments are always behind, huh? Hi, Jane. Yeah, so gorgeous, gorgeous card, you see? So that is done with florals number 5. But then, to honor, like Anita as well, look at the work. You see how different? And with the same set. And again, that's what I love about it. Oh, there we are. Yolanda. And Anna, can you... So Yolanda Etman is the winner. And Anna, do you have the one for Monday for me as well? Because, oh, Monday giveaway winner, Yolanda. Oh, then I need the one from Friday that I had to announce on Monday, Anna. So the one that I had from Friday that I had to announce on Monday. I need that one as well, please. So congratulations. Oh, Ribbit Prills. Okay, so those prills are not the prills from... I have some prills as well. Yeah, Yolanda. Happy, happy. Yeah. So florals 5. And before I go on about the florals... Leaf Green Archival. Oh, thank you so much. Okay, Leaf Green Archival. And do you use like a Q-tip or like a eyeshadow applicator or something for the center to go out? I think that's what Anita does. So you might do that as well. So, and before I forget to say, so the florals. We probably, and I don't know for sure, but we will probably get a gap. Because we might be getting sold out of some of the florals, the new ones. And because of Chinese New Year, it's going to take a little bit longer, to almost till the end of February, before they get back in stock. So don't wait till we have them on the website. That will happen next Monday, by the way. So next Monday, we will have them on the website. But I don't know if everything will be there. So don't wait. Buy them now if you want them. Don't wait. So, that one. That's one card. There's so much to show and tell. Okay, then one of the... You know, I'm going to get one of the... the first release. This one. So, this is 1773 Florals 1. Oh, Tracy. Tracy. Tracy, contact me. Yeah. So this one, that is florals number 1. And look, so this is the original from the packaging. You see, so you have these 3 flowers and then the leaves there. What Karen did, look how different, you see. And again, love that. So just a beautiful, soft toned floral, just gorgeous. And what I see here, and... I know, Karen, you work a lot with the paper from something 49. Something 49. But she will tell you on Friday as well. She will tell you on Friday. So what you see here, there is some glitter on here. You see the fans. And I love the use of the fans. I love the use of the fans, Karen. Behind the, you know, I never did that myself. Look at that. So that's the ornate gateway from Ilse and Charlene. So from the art journal line, I see some, it's paper, and I think, if I'm correct, Karen rubbed it with gold paste. And I see some of that same paste on the cardstock as well. So she probably took like a finger and kind of rubbed it on there. But you see, just gorgeous. Just gorgeous. And then, so here you see, those are these florals. But then the little white ones, and again, can't stress that enough, can't tell that enough, mix and match. Because that small floral there is from, let me see. No, not this one. I know I have it here. I think I have it here. Ta-ta-ta-ta. Do I have it here? I don't know. I thought I had that dye here. Oh yeah, here it is. Wait. Wait for it. Here, it's this one. So this is florals number 3. And that's the little flower there. So, and I'm going to leave this here because I have another card with that. You see, so this little flower is from this set, you see. So mix and match. Hi Petra, hi Claudia, Judith, and Lillian. So all these cards for the people that tuned in later. These cards are cards from Karen Gerber. So not from my hands. And if you see, I see something about pale blue. And that's, of course, that's the flower itself. But if you look in the center of these flowers, you see some darker color there. And that gives the depth, and there's the flower centers. So Karen has different flower centers in here. I see some tiny white ones there. And then I see some dark blue or even black ones. And I know there's so many different stamens available. And yeah, I got them in a big box from Tracy. I got them in a big box from Karen. But they fit. We have boxes. I have them here. And we don't have them in the Netherlands. But I know that same company is in Europe as well. So you will absolutely be able to get them there. I don't know if these are 6x6 cards. Yeah, they are. So you can get those clear boxes. So I know we had them on the website in the US. But I don't know if we have them on the website in Europe. I don't think so. But you can get them there, you see. And that fits perfectly. So that's a 6x6 box. But I know... Oh, yeah. You buy these? Yeah, plastic dimensional boxes. Yeah, I think Karen has these then as well. And you can actually put a label on here if you want to. You can actually put a label on there. But you, of course, you can also make your own boxes. That is also possible. Yeah, Karen, yeah. That's what I thought. Thank you. So... And it's from clear, where do we get it? Clear, I don't know exactly where we get those, but they're available. If you Google that, so if you Google clear boxes, you will find that. So again, Ornate Gateway, the little flower here from this set. And then You're Amazing, that's a stamp set. And then with the banner, love it. Love it, love it. And add some glitter, some sparkle. So, this floral was from this set, and Karen also sent me a card. I didn't know I was going to get so many, but that is this one. And that is this set. So, here she only put a flower from this one. Here she used these leaves and these flowers. You see it, I'm pretty sure there's prills here again, prills in the center. The berry branch from the first release. Clear bags, yeah, I think so, clear bags. Yeah. And so the berry branch from the first relief, prills in the center there, or something that looks like it, but it looks like prills for sure. And then again, some glitter there. And I know I have, like, if you want to add glitter, I think Karen does that with, but she will probably show you on Friday, but just a little brush and then a wet glue that dries clear. And then, yeah, bubble mailer would work too. Yeah, Angelique, because the flowers are actually not, because we always think that those flowers are so fragile. They're actually not. They're very sturdy. And I think Karen wets the paper as well. I think she wets the paper. So if you put this in a bubble envelope, it will, yeah, it's prills. Thank you. It will arrive okay. That's not really. And I love how she offset the rectangles here. Just live for the moment. Very nice. So lovely, lovely card. So that's from the first release, actually. So that's from the first release. So let's put these aside. So again, it's going to be a short one. It's only going to be the show and tell. Only going to be the show and tell this time. Because I really watched TV. I had to, you know, drop the grandkids off at school. Because we can do that. This one. Florals number 9. And again, don't wait. If you want the florals, don't wait till we have them online. Because I cannot guarantee anything for Monday. So just want to make sure that I told you that. Love what Karen did here. So two tags. So you can use your tag dies from the Planner Essentials or any journal elements. This is a, she bought this one that is kind of one of those wood images that she has here. And then here Karen used this floral, so florals 9. And I know you love these cards as well, so different. But you see, so different, but so gorgeous all. So I, you know, again, just do whatever you love to do. So, and here, so curl different way, prills again in the center, some yellow in the center, and then like this, so curled backwards, and then curled upwards, you see? So backwards, and then the center kind of comes up. Oh, and she made buds as well. I saw that here. So she had buds on a little wire here. You see, if you look at this, again, it's a little bit dark, but here, you see, so she made buds. And she used, let me see, let me turn this around. No, she used a smaller flower. She did not use this one. She used a rounded one for that. So I think she used a flower that is in one of the other sets. She, no, not this one. I think she used the one with the hole then in there that has the hole in it. Yeah, the buds are really nice. No, not this. All the sets I grabbed don't have it. I know it's in a few sets. Let me see. I think she used this one. So to make the green, there's one here that has a hole in it. But these are the more rounded. The size of this card. Do I have a measure? This is a kind of an odd size for me. Yeah. You know, I don't travel light. I try to take everything. So the size of this one is 6 inch. So 6 by 7. 6 by 7 inch, this one. So if you want to use the box that we just that I just showed you, you can also make this one like a 6 by 6. It still fits the flower arrangements, you see, because 6 by 6 would be this. So you can still kind of make the same. But then, you see, I can go to the, I can build a house here, well prepared for everything. So text, again, little ribbon. And here, so to the same size, offset a little bit. This as well. And then this, and what's in the center here? Oh, there's a little green one. She actually sent me some of the centers, but there's a little green center in here. So this one is just one of the florals, which will be the smallest one for sure. Or this one, I think for this one she used this one, and then for the two small ones she used this one, and then something like this to go around. Yeah, mooi, hè? Nice, hè, Petra. Yeah, Els the builder. Yeah, Jona, you would be surprised. You would be surprised. I did a lot of I love to paint walls and that kind of stuff, but building not so much. But I always take a measuring in my bag. I have a measuring thing as well, because if you go somewhere you might just need it. It's one of the things that's in my handbag. I know everybody has their own weird thing. So again, gorgeous, and there is some glass glitter on here for sure. So that's kind of so very sparkly, gorgeous. So that's this one. So again, mix and match. Oh, and you see, this leaf is from one of the leaves and branches. So from this set, leaves and branches, you see? I see that one here. So she incorporated that as well. Gorgeous. I really have treasures here now. And I have Hochanda, like the 26th. So I'm so happy with all these gorgeous samples from Anita and from Karen. Okay, that's that one. Okay, so since I have this one, let's get this card. Oh my, oh my. Look how gorgeous. So this one, so has the paper. And I love when I see that. So confession for me. That paper, I see other people use it all the time in the planner as well. For me, it was a little bit harder to use in my planner somehow. So, oh, Angelique as well, yeah. Angelique, you have it with you to measure if you can put papers through the mail box from people. No, I always have it with me. Yeah. So the paper from the Reminiscence, the book. And when I saw this, I thought, wow. And I actually have another card to show you. This one with the papers. Yeah, I love that, Claudia. Yeah. Yeah, every single card is amazing, for sure. So different centers here. And I noticed that Karen made her cards like mostly standing up. And that's actually really nice for the flowers. So they fold open like this. So then you see, it's easy to stand up. So great coloring, of course, again. Soft finish cardstock. I have no idea what that white stuff is, what she has on there. There is white on there that is not glitter. I think it's kind of a powdery thing. And the hearts, so this one. And of course, I have so many beautiful, and again, what I love with our florals. So use the different sizes, but then just that one single small one, this one here, as a separate flower in a different color. Love that. And again, some greenery here underneath here from that set, again from the florals and from the leaves and branches. And then the fishtail again. Gorgeous card. And of course, you saw that here just to show you how different this can be. Look at that. I think, I know Anita will never come to Canada. She will not travel that far. But these two ladies should meet. What would we get then? My goodies. That would be nice. Here, look. If I just put this here, look at that. Doesn't it make you happy? Isn't that a gorgeous sight? That is just really, really nice. Oh, Claudia, you ordered them already? Good idea. Yeah, just love that. Love it, love it, love it. Alrighty. I don't know, Anna, did she post the one for Friday? I probably totally missed it. I will talk to Anna after the live and see if we did. So this one is florals number 6. Florals number 6. Then we go to, let's do this one here, florals number 8. So again, same paper from the Reminiscence the book. Love that. And these centers, I actually got some. Does she have them hiding in here? Oh, look what she has. So here, these are actually these, and so these centers, such waterbolletjes, how do you call it? Cotton balls centers. But they are, is this your favorite, Karen? This one? They're all gorgeous. They are all gorgeous. Hi, Betty. Betty was showing gorgeous flowers here. So the cotton balls, and that's what she has here. And this one she colored in the green, kind of as more like a bud in the center. But then I also noticed that she has one in here. You see, so there is one in here, and then she colored that one in the color of the flower itself. And this could be a rose type of flower. But you know, we didn't design it as that, but that's what it could be. And look at the white flowers there. Just, I love it. Love it. And then here she has another one hiding here. And Karen, if you can show how you apply the glitter on Friday, that would be great. So I can see it as well. Look at this. See? Isn't that gorgeous? It is absolutely gorgeous. And actually, she glittered this whole part as well. So this can be done also. I don't know if there's... No, this was not glittery paper. She, it is from the Reminiscence, the book. And then she stained it with like probably distress ink or something. But then you can actually put the glitter over there. The diamonds. Just a beautiful, beautiful card. Here, let me show you. You see? It's absolutely beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. So this is florals number 8. And then I should not... Wait, I have two more to show you. This one. Oh, Linda, now this is your favorite. Linda, I saw your message. I need to look into it. I saw it just before the live. I will get back to you. I think you have a parcel somewhere hanging hanging in shipping again. It's the glitter duster. Thank you, Angelique. I actually have that at home, I think. I think I have that at home. Yeah, Tracy, my wish list is growing with all the little bits to go with them. Yeah. Yeah, they are amazing. Yeah, Nancy, they really are amazing. They look like they take so long to do, but look stunning. Debbie, I have to say, because Karen was sending me pictures as she made them. And then she sent me a message, you know, that they take some time to make. But the amount, like the time in between the two, oh, yellow is your favorite color, Betty. Isn't it gorgeous? Yeah. So the time it took her in between the different cars was actually not that long. So, but it is also super relaxing to do. It is super relaxing to do. So what I see here, of course, so that's this one, Florals 7. You see, so totally different. Totally different. What I see here, and when I saw that again, I love that. So these are the tags from the Wave Pockets. So that's the Wave Pocket tag. Love that. Love it. And then circle, roughed up the paper a little bit. You know, I use that thing a lot as well. Just gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And in the center, I was going to ask you, Karen, but I forgot. Those are little pearls for sure. So there are little pearls in the center, you see? They're little pearls. But there is glitter there as well. So did you use just a blob of glue? The lottery, that would be great. Yeah. Is it a blob of glue, Karen? And then you put the pearls in there and just add some glue as well. Add some glitter as well. Root beer glass beads. Yeah, I have small beads for sure. Yeah, I have small beads. This may sound awful, but I have to really like someone to make and send a card like this. Sandy, it's so much fun. But also if you just one flower and then make a tag. And add it to a present. Brushed it on. But it's brushed on glue, correct? Yeah. Okay, yeah. So it's a blob of glue. And then put the pearls in there. And then add some glitter. And that could be that can actually easily be the diamond glitter as well if you want that. But if you have that. And then again, the little touch of the white flowers. Really, really, really nice. Love it. So Florals number 7. And then I have one more to show you. And let me see if I didn't forget anything. I did that one, this one. Yeah, one more. And then we're done for the day. I have another live for a store to do for Scrubbox Centrale in Montreal. But you're going to see the same, so no need for you to go there. But if Scrubbox Centrale is the store you order from, and you can do that. And Karen also, if you follow Karen, I know she has a class already ready to go with the florals, also with the planners, both sold out, I'm pretty sure. So that's why it's so nice that she will do a live. You will be there. You will be there, Diane, with Scrubbox Centrale. I have nothing new to show. It's a show and tell as well. I have more cards to show because the other ones you saw already here. But also we're going to do a little bit of glitter. Yeah, Cora, Karen did a good job. Yeah, so, Ruli, this is, so this is from the first release. And this is from another company. I don't know exactly who, but that's a nice circle here with a scallop. That is from another company. So, you know, might need to do some circles with some fun edges as well. Florals here. So this one is Florals 4, 1776. And of course, I love these elements. Use those a lot. The leaves here and then the berry branch from the first one. And then the, this is a really, really pretty card. Really pretty card. How did she build that? I need to see underneath here. Is it just built high up? Yeah. There's nothing underneath there. Just built high up. So how she built it up? A little touch of a light green in the center. And then like a peach color. Do you know... yeah, Jane. Yeah, I will see you as well. Yeah. Yeah. That pale color. Like the... Do you know which color that is? Because is that the same color as you used here? Or did you use colored cardstock here, Karen? Or is that... Did you... Yeah, you inked this as well, I think. So is that the same color of... the same color of kind of a peach color? And we would love to know. There must be silicone glue. That could be. Kids' Choice glue will work as well. Is there silicone underneath? Oei, oei, oei. You know, I cannot see. Yeah, there is silicone. You are correct. And for the silicone, I don't know which one everybody's using. I'd like to how to follow Karen as well. So Karen Gerber on Facebook. Karen, so she's here. So she just said hot glue. So that's the Karen you are looking for. So Karen is on Facebook and probably on Instagram as well. But yeah, but she posts all her cards on Facebook. So yeah, hot glue underneath. What I actually use, if you want to use hot glue, is of course dries faster. But if I use silicone, that needs to dry a little bit longer. That's true. But for silicone, I just use the caulking for the tubs. For the tubs. Because they sell it in tubes here at the craft store. At the, how do you call that? Not craft store. Building material store. Sorry, lost it. But that's why I buy my silicone. That's why. But that needs to dry. You know, that takes a long time to dry. And of course, when you do hot glue, which I did bring, by the way, you can just do a blob, push it in there and just hold it for a second and then it dries. Yeah. My tubes always dry out. Yeah, Tracy. Yeah, you know, I have to say the ones from the hardware store, I was looking for that word. The ones from the hardware store work well for me here. It takes, you know, if I use it on a regular base, it is actually pretty good. So that's this one. So a little bit of pale green, some very fine stamen there. And then like the peach color on the side. And then here she did it the other way around with the leaves. She used a little bit of peach. You see, I need to start doing that as well because I never do that. But like a little bit of peach in the center. And then the green that she used in the center here, I see on the outside of the leaves. So that is just so nice. Love to see that. Love to see that. So that is the last one. And the same flower, by the way, is of course this one. You see? So again, total different look. But love them both. This is actually one that I did. And I'm pretty happy with that one, you know. I'm not a flower artist as Anita and Karen are. But, and the blog. Thank you, Claudia, for putting the blog link as well. That's very helpful. Thank you. And Karen is on the design team as well for the flowers. And the planners. So that is it. So let's go out with a floral shot here. So just some of the cards from Karen. And then you saw all that. We have all the pictures. Karen posted all these cards on her page already. So you can find all these cards on Karen's Facebook page. Look at that. You know, isn't that gorgeous? Isn't that gorgeous? That just makes people happy, doesn't it? I need a small one there. Oh, let's take the peach one here. Here you are. That's it. Is that a shot or not? Is that a shot or not? That's just gorgeous. Gorgeous. So with, you know, talented designer as Anita and help from Josette and the art from Karen, you get this. And of course, the inks from other companies and the glitters, the, like the glass glitter that I see and the prills. And so it all comes together in these gorgeous cards. So Karen, thank you. So again, like, comment and share and tell your friends that Karen will be here on the Elizabeth Craft Designs page on Friday with a live. Yeah, Valerie, these are available to purchase through your local store or online. I don't know where you are, Valerie, but you can also message me. But they are available only through stores at the moment. They will come online on Monday at Elizabeth Craft Designs, but I cannot guarantee that everything will still be there. It could be, but I can't guarantee, and I don't want to disappoint you if they're not. So, Jennifer, I'm going to make one of these to send to my aunt in a care home. You know, Jennifer, that will make her happy, and it makes me happy to know that you will do that as well. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you again on Monday. Bye-bye.